Trying to walk in the steps of the Savior.
Each and every Sunday, Pastor Darren Whiting talks to his small yet devout flock about faith and family values. He thinks he's found a candidate for president who practices what he preaches.
Governor Huckabee stands on the issues that I stand for. Socially conservative, as far as being pro-life, as far as being pro-family, which is very much why I like to support him personally.
It's support among evangelicals like Whiting that has propelled Mike Huckabee's surge here in Iowa, where some 40% of GOP caucus voters are Christian conservatives, and the former Baptist preacher is winning over more and more Iowa leaders with his staunch anti-abortion, anti-gay marriage views.
We don't question where he's at. We don't question what he believes. He's one of us. And his track record and his background has just kind of shown that.
So this is it.
This is it.
But at Huckabee's Iowa campaign headquarters, the huge challenge is turning his popularity into actual votes on election day.
And so it really is a matter of getting the organization to catch up to where the governor is. And so we're not there yet.
The campaign staff recently doubled from 6 to 14 people.
This is what success breeds.
This is what success breeds.
And added on to their tiny workspace. Aides from Arkansas headquarters are now in Iowa.
You're not just any staffer.
Not just any staffer, I guess. My dad is Mike Huckabee.
Including daughter Sarah, her father's field director. And this week, Huckabee began airing his first TV ad.
Mike's a principled, authentic conservative.
Chuck Norris doesn't endorse. He tells America how it's going to be.
Aides, including his daughter, admit they're not sure how that's going to play in Iowa, but say at least Huckabee's getting buzz, a necessity for a still underfunded, understaffed campaign.
Increased popularity equals increased scrutiny, and Huckabee's rivals are being a lot more aggressive here about criticizing him on issues like taxes and immigration, where they say his record as Arkansas governor could prove to hurt him with the very conservatives he's successfully courting. Dana Bash, CNN, Des Moines, Iowa.